When thinking about setting up a base on the moon, what's normally envisioned is a group of hard shell modules clustered together on the moon's surface, or perhaps inflatable habitats covered by regolith for shielding. In a previous video, I've covered Icon, a company that has plans to use 3D printing machines to build habitats and large structures from hardened lunar regolith. In this video, I consider an alternative, or complementary habitation structure, lava tubes. Deep beneath the moon's surface lie vast tunnels formed by ancient volcanic flows, offering natural shelters for future lunar bases. Consider the moon's surface. No air to breathe, deadly radiation, micrometeorite strikes, and extreme temperatures make the surface a brutal place to live. Yet, just below the surface, there could be a lunar lava tube, providing a natural shelter big enough for a lunar city. A long time ago, the moon was a hotbed of volcanic activity, spewing basaltic lava across its surface. As this lava flowed, the top layer cooled in the airless void, forming a solid crust. The hardened lava above insulates the molten lava below, allowing it to retain its liquid warmth and continue flowing. The molten lava kept moving, carving out tunnels. When the lava eventually drained away, either flowing downhill or seeping into the ground, it left behind vast empty tubes just beneath the lunar surface. The moon's low gravity, just 1/6 of Earth's gravity, and the lack of an atmosphere allowed the molten lava to flow further and form larger tubes than could be formed on Earth. Lava tubes on the moon can be hundreds of meters in diameter and kilometers in length. The evidence for lava tubes comes from lunar surface images that show collapsed lava channels and skylights, pits where a lava tube roof has caved in. Although lunar lava tubes have been theorized for a long time, it wasn't until 2010 when the first actual lunar cave openings or entrances into lava tubes were discovered. A Japanese satellite saw a skylight in the area of the moon's Marius Hills region. Later on, the same team found two other lunar pits at the Sea of Tranquility. Think of skylights as natural windows in a lava tube, providing entry and exit locations to a tube. To date, over 200 pits have been identified by NASA's LRO satellite, many of which are believed to be skylights. For comparison, Earth's largest cave is widely considered to be Hang Song Dong in Vietnam. This cave is so large it has a forest, river and clouds inside. This cave is much smaller than the Marius Hills skylight in relative dimensions. The pit in the Sea of Tranquility has an estimated depth of over 100 meters, twice the depth of Earth's largest cave. This gives you an idea of just how vast lunar lava tube caves can be. An entire lunar city could fit inside one of these lunar lava tubes. Not all pits are skylights. Estimates suggest that intact lava tubes could number in the dozens or more. For instance, the Marius Hills region alone shows multiple skylights and collapsed lava channels. All of this evidence has been from remote sensing. We really need to send rovers to survey these regions in more detail. Advantages of lava tubes over using the moon's surface. Why build a lunar base on the moon's harsh surface when nature offers a better solution? First, lava tubes shield settlers from deadly radiation. Solar flares and constant cosmic rays bombard the moon's surface from all directions, posing serious health risks. A lava tube's roof blocks these threats entirely, creating a safe haven. Next, lava tubes protect against micrometeorites. These tiny space rocks slam into the surface at blistering speeds, kicking up sharp debris that can damage equipment and habitats. Inside a sealed lava tube, settlers avoid this chaos, and the moon's clingy, electrostatically charged dust, which sticks to everything and wreaks havoc on machinery. Temperature control is another massive advantage. The moon's surface swings wildly from 127 degrees Celsius in daylight to -173 at night. Lava tubes, however, maintain a steady -20 degrees Celsius or -4 Fahrenheit, similar to Antarctica's McMurdo Station. This temperature stability cuts energy costs for heating or cooling. Unlike surface habitats that demand constant power from batteries, fuel cells, or nuclear reactors. Consider Antarctica, where temperatures often dip below a lunar lava tube's steady -20 degrees Celsius. Over 70 permanent stations, government and commercial, span the icy continent, supporting more than 5,000 people year-round. Scientists probe the ice, builders construct outposts, and tourists marvel at the wilderness, all thriving in this frozen frontier. Lunar lava tubes could host the same vibrant activity, research, construction, even exploration. The moon's surface brims with high-yield resources, water ice, metals like iron and titanium, and volatiles for fuel. While helium-3, a potential fusion power source, is the only resource worth shipping back to Earth, local lunar residents can mine these resources to build habitats, generate power, and propel spacecraft. By harnessing these materials, lunar bases can forge a self-sustaining lunar future, turning lava tubes into bustling hubs of activity. Construction inside lava tubes is simpler too. With natural shielding in place, lightweight materials or inflatable habitats can be used, skipping the heavy regolith needed for shielding on the surface. This simplifies construction and reduces costs. Skylights and pits like those in the Mares Hills region lie steps away from water ice, helium-3, and metals such as iron and titanium. Companies like Interlune plan to mine helium-3 from lunar soil, leaving behind oxygen and nitrogen, ideal for pressurizing a sealed lava tube to create a breathable shirt-sleeve environment where lunar explorers can live. Skylights add a remarkable touch. By capping these natural windows with transparent domes, lunar residents can peer at Earth's blue glow or bask in sunlight, blending the safety of a lava tube with the beauty of the lunar view. Far more than mere shelters, lunar lava tubes are gateways to a permanent lunar presence. With resources at hand, protection from the moon's harsh surface, these ancient tunnels could transform our lunar dreams into reality. Challenges of lunar lava tubes. Accessing skylights is a steep challenge. These pits, often 50 meters deep, have unstable, dusty slopes that trip up rovers and defy human entry without cranes or tethers. Robots will lead the way, but safe access demands breakthroughs. Sealing these vast tunnels is a monumental task. To hold air, the tubes would need to be lined with inflatable barriers or 3D printed regolith walls, a process untested at this scale. Skylight covers, potentially transparent, must withstand pressure and impacts, requiring massive resources, taking years to deploy. Moonquakes, although rare, do pose risks. Triggered by tidal forces or impacts, these quakes, which were detected by Apollo missions, can rattle weak spots, especially near skylights. Extensive robotic surveys would need to map fractures and reinforce roofs before habitation. Life support is not so simple either. Generating oxygen from regolith, recycling water from ice, and growing food by hydroponics demand complex systems in a dark, dusty cave. Power from surface solar panels or nuclear reactors must reach sprawling tubes. These hurdles, access, sealing, stability, and survival, are daunting, yet not insurmountable. XArc's proposal for lunar lava tube investigation. Imagine a lunar city thriving inside a massive underground tunnel. That's the bold vision of Exploration Architecture Corporation, or XArc, with their LEAP 2 program, Lunar Ecosystem and Architectural Prototype, targeting the Mares Hills pit. XArc is the parent company of Astroport, a lunar landing pad startup I've covered before on this channel. In a video they've posted, you can see what site development around a lava tube skylight would look like. If you're wondering why the animation is showing the South Korean flag, it's because this video was completed with collaboration from the Korean Institute of Civil Engineering and Building Technology. Here's how it works. First, robotic scouts explore the pit's rim, mapping terrain and hunting for subsurface ice to produce water and fuel. A tethered probe descends into the tube, scanning its size and stability to ensure it's safe. Once confirmed, astronauts follow, constructing habitats inside the tube's protective walls. Power flows from surface solar panels and compact nuclear reactors, creating a sustainable lunar base. ESA's Lunar Leaper. In 2023, the European Space Agency called for innovative small lunar missions. A team of European researchers answered with Lunar Leaper, a nimble 10-kilo hopping robot designed to explore a lunar skylight and give us our first glimpse into the moon's hidden lava tubes. Guess where they're headed? The Mares Hills pit, a skylight that's believed to open into a vast lava tube. From the pit's rim, Lunar Leaper will map the skylight's interior, scanning the tube's floor and walls with a gravimeter, ground-penetrating radar, science camera, and possibly a spectrometer. These tools will reveal the tube's structure, detect volatiles like water, ice, and other lunar resources. Unlike bulkier, pricier missions, this lightweight robot offers a smart, cost-effective first step pegged at 50 million euros. It could hitch a ride on a small commercial lander, making it a good fit for initial investigations of pits and tunnels. The Lunar Leaper team considers their hopping robots as the future of robotic exploration, not just for lunar lava tubes, but for Mars and beyond. MoonFiber, fiber regolith reinforced lava tube outpost. As mentioned already, lunar lava tubes offer a shielded haven for humanity's lunar future, far surpassing surface habitats. But how do we build inside these lunar caves? Enter MoonFiber, a visionary project by Vittori Netti, a space architect, to construct a permanent lunar outpost within a lava tube, harnessing local lunar resources to turn lunar soil into a lunar outpost. MoonFiber takes this further, creating a lightweight, adaptable habitat suspended inside the tube, safe from dust and debris. The secret? A revolutionary mesh of composite fibers spun from the moon's abundant soil, processed into glass or carbon filaments. Here's how it unfolds. First, rovers scout the lava tube, mapping every crevice with automated scans to pinpoint the best site. Construction equipment arrives via lander, and excavator rovers feed regolith into furnaces, spinning it into strong, flexible cables. These cables weave a suspended net, anchored to the tube's walls, forming a base for inflatable modules. The modules, housing a gym, hydroponics lab, infirmary, workshops, and living quarters, are loaded onto the net, berthed together and inflated. Rovers secure them with a final fiber weave. Two node modules connect the habitat, with radial doors linking to surface operations like 3D printing, payload unloading, and solar power stations near the tube's entrance. The result? An outpost for lunar residents, from scientists to builders, explorers, and tourists. Upcoming missions. A number of lunar lava tube specific missions have been proposed by various space agencies. None have been adopted yet. We'll just have to wait and see if governments and space agencies take more interest in exploring lunar lava tubes as future bases and settlements. What do you think about using lunar lava tubes for habitation? Do you think now is the time to investigate them? Or should we just use the lunar surface first for an outpost? Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Okay, that's a wrap. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.